Hello, beautiful Geminis. How are you today? Let's take a look and see what's happening in love for you. Thanks for stopping by. I hope everyone's doing well. Let's get the overall energy for your reading. We have a you versus them reading for you today. So we see a change is in the wind. Gorgeous. I love that bird cage on a zebra. I want that for my backyard. Okay, serendipity. So some good luck coming in, just some good timing. Gemini, you have Mars in Gemini right here, right now, higher power. It is time. You are really creating something quite beautiful in love. The fates are bringing good luck. We see the stars are developing there, and the universe is giving you a leg up in love specifically. All right, so we have, I'm going to cut the deck. I did pre-shuffle Vegas style, casino style, as we like to call it. So what we're getting here is your person. This is you. Gemini, I don't know why I feel like I need to cut these, but I do. Okay, so many times. So that's going to be you, and this is going to be your clarifier. So shuffled, I'm going to cut the deck so that we get this energy. Okay, so let's go. So in the recent past, Gemini, you have felt like you had to pack it in. Ten of Wands, the burdens of the relationship have become too much to deal with. You're at least giving up on the burdens. It doesn't mean you're giving up on the relationship, but you are definitely packing it in on that which weighs too much and is too difficult. Your person is feeling very detached at this time. They're looking away from you, but you're both looking into the future. So when you look at your person, you may be dealing with a Libra. Ten of Wands is Sagittarius energy. Your person doesn't want to have anything that really makes life more difficult. They have their heart locked away at this time. I don't think that you're talking. There's, you know, probably some distance between you physically, emotionally. You have ambivalent feelings about what you want from this relationship. You're of two minds. You know, you haven't really made a full decision. Your person is feeling very much disenchanted, but they're looking at you. You know, right now, your person is looking at you like, you know, hey, make up your mind. You're not even looking at me, Gemini, and they're looking at you. But it does look like your response of not knowing what decision you will make is a direct outcome of them turning their back or going silent on you for a while. How you see the future, the Three of Swords, you think that your person's gone off to be with someone else. Well, surprise, Gemini, your person sees you. That's actually a diamond ring when combined with a Three of Cups. So your person is, your person's going to come through in the near future, it looks like, and make some sort of offer. But, you know, you are very brokenhearted about this energy here. The Three of Swords is Libra energy. This is Libra energy. So you feel pretty pained by what has happened here. You know, I think that you've probably had some real tears over the situation. How do you view them? We see the Four of Swords. You view them as wounded. You know, how do they view you? They view you as being very fiery and passionate. What do you feel in your heart space for them? Well, a lack of trust right now. You feel as though there's a lot that you don't know. You feel as though you wish you had answers. You've done a lot of soul searching for answers, you know, but there's a lot of swords here. That's swords, swords, swords. You know, Seven of Swords energy is Aquarius energy. You've really racked your brain to try to figure this out. You know, what on earth happened in this relationship to cause a situation? So let's see how they are feeling in their heart space towards you. The Eight of Wands reversed. So the Eight of Wands reversed says that they feel very passionately towards you, but they're not taking action. How you view the future moving forward in this situation, Eight of Cups, you don't think that there's a way to move forward. You feel as though you've been forced to walk away. How do they feel? Oh, Aries energy. They feel as though they want to come back in a very passionate way, a new beginning. A Passionate New Beginning. The Eight of Wands is still no communication, but a great deal of passion for you. So we have a lot of fire and air on their side. What's the hidden energy that you have? You love this person tremendously. What's their hidden energy for you? Remorse and regret over what they've done. What is spirit advising you? Stay spiritual. Don't believe the worst. Give up on some of the negative thinking, Gemini. Your person, whatever you're thinking that they did, just may not be accurate. The High Priestess says that intuitively you know that there's something more to the situation than meets the eye. What's spirit advising them? Spirit is telling your person. The advice for your person from spirit is to manifest you, to bring the magic back into the relationship, to communicate. That, you know, spirit is saying, look at person of interest of Gemini. You have all the tools you need to make this beautiful relationship, so why don't you make magic? The outcome for the week for you, Gemini, is a desire to reconcile with your person. So even though it shows you walking away here, you're heartbroken, you know, I feel very much that your pride, which is reasonable, this person, what they did to you was broke your heart, but you really do. This is Sagittarius energy. For some reason, with Mars in Gemini this week, you're feeling more optimistic about life and love and your person. Temperance is Sagittarius energy. A lot of fire energy here. Again, how does your person, how does the weekend for your person? Ah, they want to give you something. It looks as though they feel, I'm not really fond of the Six of Pentacles because there's a sort of very measured sort of counting. Well, I did this for them, and did they do as much for me? So the Six of Pentacles is about even give and take, but we see one person giving more than the other. So your person may feel as though they've given more to you than you've given to them, but I think it's also a vice versa energy. So let's see what the clarifiers are here for you. Let's cut the deck again. I don't know why I need to do that, but I just feel it. So let's see what are, oh, you both have remorse and regret. You both have remorse and regret. And the Nine of Swords is about things that were said, things that were done, things that were not done, things that were not said. Tell us something more about that energy. The relationship has been built very slowly. It looks like you've known each other for quite a while. That is Virgo energy. It speaks to the fact that, you know, both of you slow walked the relationship. There were times it looks like both of you were working too much. Times when you couldn't see each other, times when it felt like you felt very much as though your person will at times turn their back on you, but look at, they feel the same way you did. They felt that you're both on this journey. You know, this is you, this is them. They felt that you were both on this journey and that the burdens of your individual lives sometimes were overwhelming. So it wasn't intentional on their part. The clarifier for how you feel now, you're juggling the idea, do I, don't I, what am I going to do about this relationship? Your person feels as though they should make you an offer, but they think you should make them an offer. So both of you are in this very disenchanted energy, but here, look at, this is great energy. The Eight of Coins is a clarifier, says that both of you feel that you need more mastery, that you need to know each other better. This is when we look at this card of learning and mastery is all about getting to know each other better at a deeper level, in a more grounded way. Giving more to the relationship is the energy that both of you really want. Look at the energy that clarifies the broken heart. You're both brokenhearted. You're both brokenhearted. You're both feeling a lot of pain. You're both missing each other. You both want each other. And look at what just flipped over, the Two of Cups. The Two of Cups says that you really love each other and that in the process of whatever conflict or whatever situation, I do think work has played a huge part in the two of you being apart, as well as, you know, I think even the pandemic and that sort of thing. I just feel as though you've been separated, you haven't seen each other in a while, and you're both feeling an overwhelming desire to come back together. The energy that's clarifying the way you view each other is you view each other your person views you as very fiery and passionate. You view them as somebody who's wounded you. And, you know, but you feel wounded because your person said or did something. We have three cards here to clarify. They said or did something abrupt. It left you really not understanding what was meant by that. You feel as though they could be a little bit cocky or arrogant. Whether it's true or not is another matter. But your person's very passionate, but they have a lot of pride. And I think sometimes pride gets in the way of relationships. So let's see energetically here how you view each other as the week ends, like as you're coming into this better energy. You both feel very, very like you can't let this relationship go. The devil energy means that you both feel as though the other one manipulates you. You both feel as though there's a very unhealthy element to the relationship. Why is the devil energy here? Why do you both feel that way? The Ace of Swords. Something about telling the truth. The whole truth and nothing but the truth. You both feel very emotional. You both feel very passionate. There's not any stability in this relationship. The foundation of this relationship was built on a faulty foundation. Both of you are invested. The timing is right. Both of you would really like to have a long-term commitment. The Sun card says that normally you couldn't possibly, you've never been happier with anybody else. You're not currently experiencing that happiness. Both of you want to throw caution to the winds, and both of you are sulking. Both of you have a bit of a bad attitude about this, just not being optimistic. Okay, so let's see what else we have here. Why is the Seven of Swords here and the Eight of Wands reversed? So basically what I'm seeing, Gemini, is that you feel as a, what's my person up to? And your person is feeling like, well, I can't do everything. I can't make all of the first contacts. They're sort of in a rebellion mode. And you're like, what the heck? They're like, you know, it shouldn't always be me. The responsibility shouldn't always be me. So we're seeing the reverse of the Knight of Cups, the opposite. So what we see here is a lack of communication, a lack of romantic effort. Let's see what else we have. Okay. And the heart space. Look at this. You both love each other. Look at that. This is what's in your heart space. And right now you're angry. That's your heart space. You're feeling unloved. Both of you are feeling unloved. Your person wants you to take action. So the heart space is kind of jammed up with other emotions. But here you go. That's a card of healing, Aquarius energy, the Star card, hopes and dreams for love really coming true. And both of you know. And you have to stay enlightened. Whatever's happened in this relationship has been much more, I don't think there's a lack of love. I don't even think that's the issue remotely. But what I do get is that life has interfered in your relationship. There are other difficulties in the relationship that are very mundane, that have not been handled. You know, they haven't been addressed, but both of you really love each other. That's the truth be told, that when you're alone, you really oftentimes think, I've never been happier. Why me? Why now? Why this person? And there is a magic. There's a chemistry. There's a magic. There's something about your relationship that makes you both feel very passionate, very alive, in a way that you've never felt before. Why is the Eight of Cups here for your energy and the clarifier with the Queen of Wands? Temperance. So it really speaks to the fact that you don't really want to leave. You really definitely want to make amends, but you're not going to be the one to reach out. Your person feels as though they have to be the one to reach out. So both of you want a reconciliation, but Gemini, you have given your all. You are giving it up. You're saying basically to yourself, I'm going to walk away. If they want this, they can come after me, you know. The Five of Coins says that you feel as though they left you out in the cold. The Seven of Swords says that they weren't honest. They didn't come clean with you about something. So you're absolutely right. What brought an end to the relationship was they just stopped talking. the Four of Cups, you just thought, well, heck, I mean, if they're not interested in me, I'm the Capricorn queen. I'm very capable. Mm-hmm. I have a life. I feel good about myself. I have my pride, my dignity, and I'm not going to compromise that. No matter how much I love someone, I'm not going to grovel. And so I feel very much, Gemini, that you've just been put in this situation, or you feel as though you have, you love somebody deeply, but if they don't carry their burden in the relationship, what can you do, you know, if they're in the process of just really neglecting it, or, you know, not addressing the things that need to be addressed. Look at this energy that's hidden. This person makes you feel like an empress. When you're with them, you feel really beautiful. You feel good about yourself. You feel as though, you know, just there's something about your chemistry together that just makes you open up. Why is your person feeling this way? Yeah. Look at this. They feel as though they let you go to create more stability in their life because they couldn't handle something that you had to say, some observation that you made. The Two of Swords is conflict that they don't want to deal with. So your person avoids conflict. I would say that. They avoid conflict and they will do almost anything to get out of it. But look at the energy between the two of you, the Ten of Cups. You both want your happily ever after. Spirit is giving you advice to stay quiet and to keep your own counsel. It's giving your partner, your love interest, the advice that they have everything it needs that they need to put this back in action. The energy of the Knight of Wands reverse says that you're not going to fight for this. You're taking a passive role. So the Nine of Wands reversed is, you just don't have a lot of fire in your belly to fight outwardly. You know, mentally, it looks like you're doing laws of attraction work. This is your card, Gemini. So it does speak to the fact that both of you, this is Virgo, Gemini energy. So you might be dealing with a Virgo or an earth sign. But what we see here is that you're going to keep quiet. You're not going to do anything actively. You'll draw them in through laws of attraction, but that's it. The Two of Wands says that your person, spirit is advising your person to make a decision to come forward. Here's an offer. There we go. I like it. So what we see is by the end of the week, your person wants to make this offer. They make the offer. So let's see what else we have here for that energy of the offer. Yeah, the World card, they want a new cycle with you. They want to be successful with you. So what else do we have? They don't want conflict. So your person is very averse to even the slightest idea that they could have done something wrong. Remember that when we look at Five of Swords energy, it's Aquarius energy. Aquarius can say things that are very sharp, that are wounding, and they're very true, they're very accurate, but this person does not handle conflict well. It throws them out of balance, and they feel as though words spoken, this is your energy, Gemini, that you worry too much, that they have been there for you. They feel as though they have done what they should do, and they're just completely averse to being blamed and so forth. But that is a conflict. Let's see what spirit has to give you for advice in this connection. So we're going to look at you first, and then we're going to look at your person. The advice for you in this connection, Gemini, is use your willpower. Stay yourself. You know, when we look at the willpower, we see someone who's very true to themselves. So, you know, keep your willpower and accept whatever they say to you as the truth, because it is honest, you know. It seems like they're sneaky, but this person doesn't really have all that. They're not really great at being sneaky, even if they try. Nourish the relationship and have patience with this person. Let's see what their advice is with you. Let's see their advice for the relationship is resist. Oh, they resist growth. So the advice is not to resist growth. So this person's very sort of a stuck in their ways, sort of earthy energy. it speaks to the fact that they see growing as being more, much more Virgo energy. Well, I do everything slowly and I don't make any decisions quickly. And, you know, of course, that's the way I am. They do need to make some changes in their life. They need to move forward. But, oh, wow. Extremes of passion. So Spirit is advising your person to be very passionate, to come forward, to let you know how they feel, to enjoy making love, to really embrace the heat, the fire, and energy of this relationship. Sending you love from Chicago. Send some back. Tell me where you're from, Gemini. Bye-bye.